bless you today, Saints. Happy Valentine's Day. I want to take some time today to speak a word of encouragement and inspiration to those in our listening audience today. Oftentimes, I find that the holidays can be some of the most lonely and depressing times for many people, because those who seem to have someone to celebrate holidays with, since today's Valentine's Day, and it seems to be a very important day to lots of women who are involved in relationships. I'm sure their wives expect their husbands to bring them flowers or maybe chocolates. Even at the daycare center, where we have a security contract, I noticed that the parents will bring Valentine's gifts, presents, and flowers for the staff and teachers, as well as the students sharing Valentine's greetings with their fellow classmates. So perhaps someone listening today, you may not have that. You may not seem to have that type of connection. You may not feel valued or feel loved. But I want you to know today that you are loved and you are lovable. And so prayerfully, I want to use a few words of inspiration and scripture that will speak to how we first love ourselves inside. And the way that we do that is by embracing or accepting the love that only Christ can give. For as the scripture tells us, there's no greater love than this, that a man would lay down his life for a friend. And I want you to know today, Saints of God, that God considers you a friend. We are not only children of God, but we are friends of God. And so Jesus thought enough of us. He thought enough of you and I to sacrifice his life for us. And he sacrificed his life to be a sacrifice for the peace, the love, and the joy that he prayed that we would experience in life. So with that in mind, I want you to dwell about, think about the love that God has for you by giving his only begotten son. As you, most of you are probably pretty familiar with a text of scripture from the book of John chapter 3 verse 16, which basically reads that God so loved. Say that with me, God so loved. He loved the world. The way that he expressed that he loved the world was by the giving of his son, Jesus Christ. The way that Christ proved that he loved the Father and loved us so much was that he laid down his life. And it didn't end there, children of God. If love had ended with Jesus' death, we would have love that would fail. But the love continued. And the Holy Spirit brought Jesus back to life again, to show that his love is enduring, his love is everlasting, his love is eternal. This is the love that I want you to be able to embrace today, not just on Valentine's Day. But Jesus will be your Valentine every day for the rest of your days. And I'm encouraged to know that as well, because there is no greater love than this, that a man will lay down his life for his friend. So again, a couple of verses of scripture to hit on this thought. John 3:16, from the New International Version, it reads, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." Also want to give you a scripture that speaks to the fact that there is nothing that can separate us from the love of Christ. Nothing or no thing. Nothing can separate us or change his love for us. Now, unfortunately, with relationships, people fall in what we call in and out of love. The relationships end, people break up, But I want you to know, this love that Christ gives us is a love that cannot, nothing can separate us from this love. You see about this in Romans chapter 8, verse 31. And then for these verses, Romans 3, chapter 8, verse 31 through 39 reads, "What shall we say about such wonderful things as these? If God is for us, who can ever be against us? Since he did not spare even his own son, but gave him up for us all, won't he also give us everything else? Who dares accuse us whom God has chosen for his own? No one, for God himself has given us right standing with himself. Who then will condemn us? No one, for Christ Jesus died for us and was raised to life for us. And he is sitting in the place of honor at God's right hand pleading for us. Can anything ever separate us from Christ's love? Does it mean he no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity or persecuted or hungry or destitute or in danger or threatened with death? For as the scriptures say, for your sake we are killed every day. We are being slaughtered like sheep. No, despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loved us. I'm convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love. Neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below. Indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen."